We can also have the random dates in Excel. And for that, what do? We have to use a function date value that we've already done. Let's see how it can be done. So I say equal to rand between. Let me write that on the Excel sheet. It will be more clear. So we can have the random dates also. So I say rand between bracket, and we have the option of either we can use the date value function or we can use the date function also. So first of all, let's see with the help of the date value function, and then maybe we can have a look at the date function also. So the date value function will, we all know what it takes. It will actually take a date and give you a value that represents that particular date. So it is rand between bracket date value, bracket again, quotes, 1, quotes close. And then further, I'll give another argument for the upper limit separated by comma. So when I write date value and I put a date as an argument, I put comma. And I write another date value function. I put another date over here. I write and I close the bracket. Let me check the function one more time before I stop it. And then I'm going to press enter and see the desired result. We need to remember one thing, that the same thing can be easily undertaken with the help of the date function also. So let me press enter, and there's a double comma. I can see that. So let me remove that. There's a missing, okay. I didn't put that extra bracket. So let me write it over here. Wait. And one bracket I have to put for rand between also. So again, it is giving me the error. Let me check where I have put that small. Oh, I didn't put the. Wait, let me just click OK. Let me go to this bar and let me correct this function before I move further. So I say this date value, then I say enter. This time I've got the right answer. Now remember, this particular number is coming in the date, in the number format. And if I convert this into the, wait, let me convert that in the date format. So randomly it will give me the date that is between two dates which are there in the rand between. And I've used the date value function for this. So let me, okay, I can use that. And I say, okay. And you will see that I've got the date of 1st June 1999. I wanted to have a date between 1st of June 1999 to 1st of August 1999. And randomly I got the date of 1st of June 1999. Let me drag this and let me see what I get. And you will see that each function given separately in the different cells has given me a separate date. And you will also see that these dates are indeed between the range defined in the rand between, that is 1st June 1999 and 1st August 1999. So that was all that we can have with the help of the rand between function, wherein we can have the random numbers, we can have the random date, and we can also have the random time. For that, we can use very easily. How do we do that? For getting the random time, Excel system times are stored as decimals. We can use the standard Excel rand function to insert random real number and then simply apply the time format to the cell. For example, let me just get that. If I simply write, and if I now, okay, and let me write this over here. And now I'm going to convert this in the time format. So I will say time, give me in this form. So you will see that I've got now time in this format. And simply if I drag this down, you will see that I will actually get the different answer for the cells wherever I'm dragging my rand function, just to have a different time for that matter. So we have seen in today's class how we can use rand function and rand between function to get random numbers, random dates, or even the random time. We also have the criteria where we can get random characters also. We can get random characters with the help of the char function. How do we do that? We can get random letters. So let's try to do that. For that, we have to use char character, char function, and we're going to use code function also. So let's get it and let's see how it can be done. So I say equal to char. Let me write it over here. Equal to char, curly bracket, and I'm going to write rand between. And in this case, I'm going to mention another function, that is code. In a similar manner, I'm going to use this code function and write Z over there. And I will simply close the rand between function and then the curly bracket for the char function. Let me have a look at the function that I've written over here. So it is char curly bracket rand between bracket code bracket, like this. I don't have to use the curly bracket. I can simply use a round bracket over there because that will suffice. So let me complete this check also. And then I'm ready to press enter. And this time I've got O as the answer. Let me drag this cell to the other cells and let's see what I get. So you can actually see in some cell I'm getting M, O, S, G, F, R, Q. And in the other cells, I'm getting answers like S, W, G, N, and so on. So today we just saw how we can use a random and rand between function in order to get the random numbers in the decimal form or in the absolute form. We can also have the negative numbers. We can have the date, we can have the time, and we can also have the integers, or we can also have the letters individually with the help of the different combinations of the functions. Like for the letter, we use the combination of char, rand between, and code. For the date, we use the function of rand between and date value. For the time, similarly, we can use the combination of the different functions altogether. So that was all for today. We'll be back with another concept. Till then, take care.